I'm Alim. I've been an entrepreneur for 1 year here in Aarhus. I've moved to Denmark 2 years ago, and I have been working in corporations for the last 12 years in different positions. I started working when I was 18, and then when I moved here 2 years ago, I just felt the need of a change, and that was my main driver, because I felt a little bit that I was not doing enough for my personal growth and professional growth. So I moved here for studies, and I went to Business Academy at Innovation and Entrepreneurship.
Why Aarhus and not some other location in the world?
There's, from my point of view, a nice story about Aarhus in my life, because I have been here before moving to Aarhus. I've been 4 years before. I had a very good friend who lived here, and she was doing her master thesis here at Aarhus University. And I was thinking that I wouldn't like it because it's a small town, a small city, and it's like, okay, maybe that's not the way to go. But when I came here and when I came to Denmark, I really felt connected with the country. But specifically with Aarhus, it's like you have this thing here in Aarhus, okay, it is small, but it is big at the same time, because you get to know a lot of people and you get to connect with a lot of people, and people are really nice and welcoming, and that was the spirit of the city was really impressive. I have been always living in big cities, and I've never felt so connected with the small city life, and yeah, I thought it's a good option.
And you said you were working in a corporation?
Yes.
For 12 years?
Yes.
That's in Romania?
I have been working in Romania and also in UK. I have been working for Royal Bank of Scotland there.
And then you decided to become an entrepreneur. Was it because you weren't happy with...
No. I've been an entrepreneur in Romania also. I had my own business of financial consultancy services that I have been doing for different companies, small and big companies. I've had a really big project when I did that. However, I didn't feel like I had the... because my small business was, I had it for about 3 years at that moment, and I didn't feel at that moment this drive as of entrepreneurship, and that's because it wasn't seconded by knowledge. It was something that I did because of the network and because of the people that I have already met in Bucharest. And I said, okay, I'm going to shift towards entrepreneurship. However, at that moment I said, okay, I'm going to stop after I finished my projects. And I went back into a corporation in the medical field. The second time around, when I did this, what was really interesting was the fact that I actually learned mechanisms of how to do it and how to deliver a business and how to work in a setup that I wasn't used to before, and that's how I made the business in itself also, because I felt more empowered to do it at this moment. I think it's also about a little bit more wisdom and a little bit more experience in dealing with this type of things, because when you're an entrepreneur, from my point of view, you need a little bit of experience to actually deliver a business in the end from different perspectives.
And that's all that starts with trying.
Yes, it starts with trying, definitely. You need to try, you need to fail, because we talk about failures a lot. You need to fail a lot, and you need to try and try and try until you get it right. I don't believe that I'm the role model from this point of view. I've never considered myself as being the role model. But I think that at some point you can become an inspiration for others to do certain things. I take things to a level, and then I need also to work with myself to surpass that level and to go even further. And it's a game. Entrepreneurship is a game about with yourself and with the rules and the setup that you have around you, but especially with yourself, how you deliver on a daily basis, from my point of view.
What were the biggest challenges you met when you moved to Aarhus?
I don't. That's a question that is. I've been asked this a few times, but I don't see things that I have like challenges. I don't see them. Not even challenges. I think they were normal. This is the new normal. Put it like this. Yeah, because if you start complaining about what is happening, then you're not going to deal with anything in the end. You're just going to complain, and no action is going to come out of it. Yeah. So I don't see them not even as challenges. I think it was the new normal for me to stretch myself out and find new people and talk to new people and go to networking meetings and go to a different school that I haven't been used to, because I come from a country where education is totally different than the education in Denmark. Finding a house, there's a different system here than it is in my country. Making new friends, it's a new, different system than it is in my own country. So I don't see it as a challenge. I just see it was a new normal that I had to adjust to, and those were the things. But of course I had the same, let's say, issues or challenges as everybody: finding a new house, making new friends, connecting with people, networking, developing a business, coming up with an idea for a business, or all these things. So I had the same issues. But again, it's something that if you feel passion for, you're just happy that you're doing them. And every day is so empowering and is so perfect, even though you have a lot of things that don't go the way that you actually thought they would go.
I think things never go the way you think.
No, never. But that's a good thing. That's the best thing that you need to learn generally, because things are not going to go the way you want them to go. And when I came here, for example, I didn't have an expectation to make a business. What I was attracted of, I had this attraction towards innovation. That was my main focus. Entrepreneurship, as I said, I've done it in Romania, I failed, and I thought that I'm not going to do it again. But I have, from my humble point of view, I have an innovative mind, and I have a lot of ideas that come on a daily basis, but I didn't necessarily know how to put them and how to connect the dots. Yeah. So I was focused on innovation. I didn't think that these studies that I'm going to make, they are actually going to bring out a business that's going to grow and will provide the jobs and make money and all these things.
I want to ask you about the failure in entrepreneurship in Romania, because since you will be one of our speakers, I really want to hear it live on
yes.
our stage, so that would be really looking forward to find out about your story. But it's really nice that we can get to meet you and to know who will speak and who will share a story.
Yeah. I'm one of them.
Yes, who was the one that failed and now is coming to tell us? Aline. But I think you're really brave to do that. I'm really happy you will be one of our speakers.
Thank you.
It would be really great if you can tell me more about what you do now. And you told me a little bit about the personal development, what you want to do with. And
yes. I have a few projects that are running in the same time. At the same time, I work. I couldn't let myself go from corporation, so I work in a really cool department in a bigger company here in Denmark, where I'm dealing with innovation processes, with business development, and with business models. And these are the things that I'm really passionate about. I have my own business. It's a business in which we deliver household services in the shared economy principles, with the shared economy principles. Basically, we have freelancers that are matched with customers. I work only with private customers. I don't work with B2B, so I don't go into the business-to-business part. And that's because I want to bring an added value to people and not to companies. And that's my philosophy that I have been developing for a long time. I believe that people are the ones who need more help than the business in itself as a setup. And that's where I think that I can bring an added value with my knowledge and with my experience, and I love working with people. And the third thing that I'm doing, I have sort of coaching schedule that I do with small businesses in Romania, because Romania is a country in which entrepreneurship is not does not have the entire tools, or doesn't have the tools that we have learned here in Denmark. So I work with some small businesses, really really small businesses, with entrepreneurs who need help in setting up a business model, or in innovating in something, or just guiding them in how the next step should be done, in shaping the strategy, and depending on the needs of the company. I'm not doing this with a lot of people because I don't have a lot of time, but I'm doing it just with five small businesses that are from different domains of activity. And I think that's the thing that is really cool for me, and maybe I will develop it more in the future. But all the things that I'm doing, they have one thing in common, and that's people, because I really love working with people, and that's my passion, actually, to work with people as long as I will live.
Since I met you, I saw that you're very ambitious. So yes, you are. I saw a few lectures that you hold, and it's always you get to catch the audience, to give them all a lot of advice, and I think it's really good that you can work with people and you like that. Everyone can see that. I'm sure our audience will see that too.
I hope so. I'm a little bit nervous about it, and I'm going to be honest here. I'm a little bit nervous about it because it's very hard to work with people from my point of view. It's either they believe that what you are saying is the ultimate truth, either they say it's bullshit. There are two sides of the coin, and I understand both of them. I have no problem with it. I believe that in the end you are entitled to your own opinion. My thought behind this, and my thought behind having a speech at this event, that it's okay to fail, it's not because I want to teach people something, or a recipe of success or whatever, because I don't believe that I am successful in the way that people look at different role models that they have. But I believe that there is a need of inspiration, and that's the most important thing, because people nowadays feel a little bit misguided, or they don't have the necessary drive to do some things, or they just feel like, okay, that's not the moment for me, and they wait, they sit back, you know, and that's what I want to talk about. It's not a moment to sit back, it's not a moment to not go out there and to test a lot of things. It doesn't matter if you have traction with millions of people or with just 10 people. You have to try to bring your small added value to the world that we live in. When you create something, and that's something that you learn in the innovation processes also, when you create something, you need to provide an added value to somebody, which is going to be your customer segment. If the customer segment is big or small, that's another problem. But even if it's small, you need to try to deliver it to those people, you know. And I think that that people are in need of this kind of inspiration, and let's do it. Let's do mode, you know. Because sometimes we get lost along the way, and I see a lot of smart young people that just maybe because of the structure where they are, or maybe because of the fears that they have, or maybe because of relationships that they have or don't have at this moment, they feel, okay, am I the suitable person to do it? Am I the right person to go for it? And of course you are. We all are. There's no recipe in which you have to be like Steve Jobs, or you have to be like Elon Musk, or you have to be... There's no recipe from this point of view. These people are where they are because they believed in themselves, you know? So that's what we need to learn on our own. It's the fact that I don't have to look alike as somebody. I have to be myself, and that's it. And if that's good enough for some people, that's fine. If not good enough for a lot of people, that's also fine. You know, you just need to find your target audience, and then you'll be able to work. And it's irrespective if you're working in your own business or in a company, or you will always have people that they will say, no, you can't do that. No, you can't do that. I heard that like 1,000,000,000 times in my life. But you have to overcome it, and you will definitely feel more. You will feel better after you overcame a lot of stuff.
I'm sure you've heard this question 1,000,000 times, so I might formulate it differently. The question of where do you see yourself in 10 years?
No.
But it's more like, not a question, it's more like, you already told me your vision is to work with people, so
yes.
I assume that all your life would be to work with people. But what is the vision of how would you help these people around you, and how do you imagine yourself doing it?
I don't have a 5-year plan or a 10-year plan, because I believe in actually living in the moment and connecting with you right now at this interview. And I believe that when I woke up this morning, I went to the gym and I thought, okay, I'm going to come and have this interview, and I'm going to have to think about what I'm going to say and put ideas that are really clear forward. I don't have this vision of what's going to happen, but what I know for sure is that I will definitely provide educational systems to people. I believe a lot in education. I believe that people need to be educated so that they can survive in the world that we live in. Everything that is happening around us is about technology, is about fast pace, instant gratification. All these things, you cannot manage them without actually being educated on how to do it. How are you going to deal with every single aspect of your life? Imagine tomorrow that you're going to have a house in which you just enter, you snap your finger, and then you're going to light the room up, you're going to cook instantly, you're going to do all these things. How is that person going to acquire all the knowledge that they need to do it? So I believe in education, and I believe that I'm going to help a lot of people by, I don't know, making schools or making programs of education. I don't know where, I don't know how, I don't know when, I really don't know these things. But I believe that this is the key that I'm going to follow. Because again, I believe that education is the one that is going to provide you with a lot of inputs. I had a discussion with one of the people that I coach now. He's also a young entrepreneur, he's 21 years old, and he has an e-commerce business. He's finishing his first part of the bachelor here in Denmark, and we were talking the last couple of days about, okay, I don't want to go, I don't want to make my top up because I think it's unnecessary, I have this business, everything is going fine, I will grow my business, everything is going to be fine, perfect. And I said, yeah, okay, that seems reasonable, you're making a good amount of money on a monthly basis, that's really good, and you basically can live anywhere in the world, so that's fine. However, how are you going to stretch yourself a little bit more? If you go out there and you say, okay, I'm going to be an entrepreneur, you will definitely not have only one business. You will definitely develop your business in different areas. Because again, the world is moving very fast. So at one point you will realize that I'm going to have cleaning as a main service, of course, like, or whatever is going to be, let's say, yeah, because I have a startup which provides these services, and cleaning is one of the main. But I'm in the position in which, okay, I can provide this also, and another service, and another service. How am I going to stretch myself in providing this? How am I going to think of things, how those services are going to be sold? Because there are different selling methods that you need to provide. And you cannot do it without knowledge. Of course, you have to have a good, a good feeling and a gut sense that tells you, okay, I need to move this direction or this direction. But if you don't educate yourself and you don't educate your gut feeling on how it should primarily go and which are going to be the steps, then you're gonna get into a fuzzy area then. And you're not going to be able to deliver. And I know that from my own experience when I say it. So, getting back to that, we were talking about this, and I said, okay, you have a business, what do you know? I know marketing, of course. So I said to this person, okay, you've done marketing and then you have an e-commerce business, that's fine, that there's a good match here, perfect. But your business is small. How do you want to scale it? What types of skills do you need so that you can scale it? And I said, okay, let's identify a little bit. And then we got to the conclusion that he needs experience or knowledge in finances. I said, that's your answer. If you don't know this part, you're not gonna make it. You are not gonna make it because you need innovation in finances when you're doing e-commerce businesses. Yeah, you need to innovate also in that part so that you can actually deliver a sustainable business and you can make money so that you can live happily ever after. And I really liked that discussion. For me it was a really challenging one, but it was really nice because this person has actually realized at the end of the talk that we had that he actually needs a top up in finances or something that is going to increase his knowledge from this point of view. And you also need to think very practically in life. What are your losses? What's going to be the loss? None. You're going to a free education, you're getting your free knowledge from somebody who has already experienced the things that you are maybe going through it, and you don't have to put a lot of pressure on yourself, because you don't have to be the best in school or all these things, but you need to do it. And I believe that in a little bit, if it's a little bit structured, that somebody is going to give you like food spoon you know, give you a little bit of books and all this, and then you're going to have a lot of it's going to be easier for you, you know. So that's what I believe in, to make the whole
circle
it's education.
It's really interesting, and I really think that we do need to get educated in different ways if we choose to, but think about how do I educate myself, and that's really important.
Yes.
Thank you for this. Really nice
to
talk about it and to meet you more. I don't want to ask you more because I really want to keep the mystery as hearing you, hearing your story, so I'm more fascinated when I hear it for the first time.
It's gonna be fun anyway, so yes. let's keep it also. I said you need to be relaxed, so we will keep
it. It's gonna be fun.
Yes.
It doesn't have to be like you will be on the stage of it's okay to fail. Like when something goes wrong, it's like, look, this is the concept, you know. So it's like
exactly.
It's the place where you can fail. You can say things that I don't know. You can do whatever.
Yeah.
Just it's a place where you grow. And I hope that it will always be a place where both our audience and our speakers grow more and open up their hearts and open up their stories with no barriers of who they are and what they've been through and how they get to where they are.
That's one of the motives that I accepted this, because you know that we talked about it, and I think that the most important thing is that if the people that are going to be in the audience, I have a takeaway out of the discussions, and I think that one of the outputs of the discussions and the talks that are going to be there, that they will feel more empowered, and that's a good output to have when you come to an event, to feel empowered in doing something, and the inspiration comes from anybody, irrespective of their social status or, I don't know, weight, height, brown eyes, blue eyes.
Yeah.
But it comes from everybody, you know, and I think that the audience is going to get inspired and they will have a blast there.
Thank you very much for this.
Thank you.
Ah!